From Washington, D.C. to your computer, this is Soundbites with Sam Farr, a timely look at issues of the day. And now, Congressman Sam Farr.
Hello and welcome to another installment of Soundbites with Sam Farr. Congressman, we're here just a day or two before our final vote on the health care legislation, at least a final vote in the House. How do you plan on voting for this bill and why?
I'm going to vote for this bill, and I'm going to proudly vote for it because I think it's really going to help people get access to affordable health care insurance. And in the long run, it's going to bring down the cost of health care and stop it from just exploding years out so that nobody will be able to afford it. It provides a lot of access to by creating exchanges and people being able to compare, shop comparison. It requires all the insurance companies to sell the same basic policy so they can't game the consumer. It does away with pre-existing conditions. There's an awful lot of people that we meet, and particularly locally, who have told me that their daughter or their mother or father has a pre-existing condition, and therefore the insurance is either too expensive or not available at all. Those things are good. I mean, we have great hospitals. People get sick, whether they have insurance or not, or whether they're documented or not, or whether they want, even those that want think they're very healthy can get into an accident. So the whole idea of being able to get those people covered so that everybody has insurance, so every cost is paid for, will be very good for our local hospitals, will be good for our local and our own and premiums. It's estimated that we pay, I think, about $1,000 a year per person in our insurance policies to cover the uncompensated costs that hospitals have to make up for, doctors' offices have to make up for. So this access is really a big issue in America, and this is why this bill is so historical, to be able to open up access, hold down costs. Because access and costs, I mean, you can go to a great university if you can get in, if you have the money. And so that's not really accessible education because there's a financial roadblock. The same is true with insurance and with healthcare, that it's out there, but unless you can pay for it, you can't get in it. And that's why we have so many people uninsured in America.
Thank you.